Konnichiwa, Rob Papen here, and this is a little video about Predator 2, which will be released hopefully at the end of November, and let me tell you more about it. And here we have Predator 2, and as you can see, it did grow a lot. We added some very nice cool features. One you will notice from the start is here the XY pad, which you can use to control the parameters in Predator 2. Down here, this section is about the same like we had in Predator, but has more pages. So not only the arpeggiator and the modulation, but also a page to control, for instance, this XY pad. So the filter section did get some changes. You can see the play mode here with some new features. And on the lower right bottom part, we have the effects section. So, but let's stay up here in the oscillator section, because there it changed a lot. Listen to this sound. What you can hear is that the sound moves from one sound to another. Well, inside each oscillator, you can morph between the two waveforms, between waveform A and waveform B. Now I use the XY pad to control this. So instead of using the dial myself, the XY is now controlling this movement of this morph dial. I can shut it down now here and do it manually. Well, of course, I can change and take another waveform. Let's take a spectrum waveform 39. Or I take another one here. Well, here you set this morphing active, and now it works in morphing mode, but you can also do interpolate between the two waveforms. And if you look to the list, we have all kind of types where you can morph between the two waveforms, which changes the sound, of course. Well, this is very new inside Predator 2. And as mentioned, you also can control it with the XY pad, which I did now here. You see the destination for the X movement is now sent to the morph one dial or parameter. But there is more, because we have, of course, the waveforms, which you know from Predator 1, but you also can make your own waveform. And in total, you can make up to 8 own waveforms. Let's go to a different preset. In this preset, we use in wave A, user 1, and in wave B, user 2. So you can also morph between your own drone waveforms. And down here is the page where you can draw your own waveform, user waves. You see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 waveforms you can draw. You can do it manually, you can use a line. What you also can do, use partials and select how many partials you're going to use. So this is creating your own personal waveform. Okay, let's show this by using user 1. So using a waveform drawing or partials drawing, this is the way in which you can make your own waveforms, or you could use one of the presets we deliver in Predator 2. Well, listen to this preset. In this preset, we use a wave set, which is also a way of using the waveforms. With wave set, it means that you can scroll through the waves 1 up to 8. So all the user waveforms you can use here, and you can use the dial to go through them, or you can use, for instance, what I said here, velocity. Or
you can use the sequencer. Let's go to the next preset. Well, in this preset, the arpeggiator is playing, and we use also the waveforms morphing. Well, here inside the arpeggiator, we have a free row. And in the modulation matrix, we can see that the free row is now connected to the morphing one parameter, which is this one. So now I can use the sequencer to change the waveform. Use the different types. This is low morphing, U morphing, ring modulation, FM. And of course, I also can say use the wave set for this, so that you use the wave set, which goes from 1 to 8, or maybe you want it from 4 to 8, it's up to you. And then it uses the sequencer to go from the from one wave, from the wave set to the other. Of course, there need to be waveforms on board, so let's draw them. Different type of morphing. And it's still just one oscillator you are hearing, of course. Can change the spread. So this whole oscillator section is very refreshing with new options in terms of making the sound. Well, this one is a very nasty sound using the wave set and going from one wave to another. But there is much more, of course, inside Predator 2. If you look into the filter section, you can see we have more multiple pages, filter 1, filter 2, and filter 1 plus 2. And in this particular preset, this filter is in split mode for filter 2, which means that essentially filter 2 is the same as filter 1. The only difference is the cutoff frequency, which is different from the filter 1, but both are spreading to the left and the right by using this pan amount. So if I open this pan amount, they go left and right, which is great for stereo sounds. Listen. And because of this, we thought, okay, this is nice if you want to have some nice stereo sound, but maybe you still want to have a high pass filter. So we added also still the high pass filter, and this is new inside Predator 2. I can put it on here. Okay, also new inside the Predator filter is another different pre-filter distortion. We call it dirty because it adds really a very nice edge. Listen to this. It's clean. Anyway, the arpeggiator is now playing, and maybe you notice it's in sequence mode, so you can tune these tabs, and it's also the case that we have Arp A and Arp B here, and you can also say join, so then it has, instead of 16, 32 steps. Okay, but let's stick to Arp A. Well, and what is also cool, not only in the filter we added distortion, but also in the amp section. Here we can have a distortion mode, and for instance, now we use a fuzz. And keep in mind, this distortion in the amp section is on voice level. So each voice, if you play two notes, each of this note has its own distortion. So if you would play chords, it doesn't interpolate or makes a growl sound. It stays very clean. So in this preset, I use the fuzz FX. Well, again, without distortion, I put the distortion off from the pre-filter and the distortion in the amp. So you can make some very nasty sounds also with Predator 2. Below the amp section we have the play mode, and new is that we have a different unison mode. For instance, 3x unison, which detuning and stereo spread. So this is the sound without unison. And now let's take, for instance, unison 3. Detune it and go stereo. But there is also more news. We have here the chord mode. If you press one note, it plays a complete chord. And once you select here the chord, for instance, three notes, you can edit it here in this middle lower section. It's called chord, and here you have the root key. Second note is seven semitones detuning. Third one is now plus 16. And each note you also can pan to the left or to the right. This is great for making this typical 90s sounds. And you also can strum it here. Or even synchronize it to your music. Well, there's of course much more to tell about Predator 2. So many new cool features. And I would say, well, just check it out once it is released. And then we will show, of course, more sounds and more tutorials.